Nasal turbinates are small structures inside your nose that help moisten and warm the air you breathe in. Turbinates look a little bit like a hot dog cut in half. On the inside, turbinates are made up of bone from the upper jaw, surrounded by nasal mucosal lining. Sometimes, turbinates can become swollen, a condition called turbinate hypertrophy, or enlargement. Common causes of turbinate hypertrophy are allergic rhinitis, what we call seasonal allergies or hay fever, and non-allergic rhinitis, which is similar to hay fever but without the allergic reaction. Enlarged turbinates can cause symptoms like congested nasal breathing, runny nose, and trouble sleeping. Your doctor can diagnose turbinate hypertrophy with a physical exam and will typically prescribe a non-surgical treatment first, like a nasal steroid spray, oral antihistamine, or nasal antihistamine to reduce the swelling. Allergy shots may also help for seasonal allergies. When medication alone does not reduce the swelling, surgery may be necessary. The surgery to shrink enlarged turbinates is called an inferior turbinate reduction, or turbinoplasty. The surgery happens in an operating room. First, you will be given general anesthesia, a medication that makes you sleep and keeps you from remembering or feeling any pain during the operation. There are three techniques used for turbinate reduction, and the one used will be determined by your surgeon based on your anatomy. The first type of procedure, a radiofrequency turbinoplasty, is a minimally invasive surgery, meaning there is no incision needed. A wand is inserted into the nose to a marker point on the device. Once inserted, the wand uses radiofrequency at low temperatures to ablate or shrink part of the swollen turbinate. This is repeated at different areas until the turbinate gets smaller. The remaining turbinate is then pushed to the side. The second type of procedure is a turbinoplasty with microdebrider. A microdebrider is a surgical tool that uses a small burr, suction, and saline to shave down the turbinate using multiple passes. After the turbinate is shaved down, the remaining portion is then pushed to the side. The third type of procedure is a partial inferior turbinectomy and is used in cases where other procedures have not achieved the desired goal. For this technique, the lower third of an enlarged turbinate is cut with a surgical instrument and removed. The procedure is often repeated on the other side. All three of these techniques create a larger passageway for air to go through when you breathe through your nose. Turbinoplasty is usually performed as an outpatient procedure, meaning you can go home the same day. Expect some crusting or drainage in the days following surgery, but if you experience significant bleeding, call the ENT nurse line. Most patients recover within 2 weeks. After an inferior turbinate reduction, you should be able to breathe easier through your nose. Call us at the Children's Hospital Colorado Department of Ear, Nose, and Throat to schedule an appointment with one of our providers.